Hello everyone, today we have new video review, and as you can see, this time we are going to talk about fresh release from Special Hobby. It's a 1/72 scale release, which copies Messerschmitt BF109E1, but this version is quite special because it is dedicated to J88 Legion Condor, and we have a commercial sample here, so it means you will get exactly the same stuff as what you will see in this video review, especially if you order it from official Special Hobby web store. Be sure that everything will be the same. But first of all, I have to notice that the box size is, I would say, typical size for this manufacturer. Here you can see comparison with my hand. We have really beautiful box art here, and also this small signs will give you an idea of which markings to expect inside. Of course, on the sides we have, new marking options profiles here, because usually we had some safety devices and now we have this marking guide, let's say, for three marking options which are here. Note that this is a limited edition, so if you want to get one, it's better to hurry. And we are going to open it right now. It's a top opening box, and here is what we have inside: assembly manual and sprues are packed together with this decals sheet. So without further ado, I am going to take it out of the plastic bag and we will check everything closer. And there are not that many gray plastic sprues. There are only two of them and one clear, so I wouldn't say that this is something surprising, especially considering the scale of this model. If you forgot, we are dealing with a 1/72 scale kit, so that's why there are not that many parts. And here we start with gray plastic parts, so let's zoom in a bit, maybe open the lenses so that it will be better visible for you. And here you can see that we have fuselage halves which are molded without cowling, because cowling is molded as a single piece part. And wing, the design I would say is quite typical. We have wing mechanization separate. Note that tail wings are molded together with elevators. And now let's zoom even further so that you can see what we have here. So recessed panel lines is something what you can expect from this kit, and quite extensive riveting. I would say some bigger scale kits do not offer such amount of details out of the box, and here you can see everything with your own eyes. It is really impressive. Of course, be sure not to overdo the paint layers and primer layers, because it will be easy to lose this details. But it's not to say that these details are quite tender. It's more of a, let's say, typical modeler's mistake when they apply a lot of paint and then they wonder where all the rivets disappeared. And here you can see also that we have some minor cockpit details, but I hope that there will be, there are decals which will help you enhance the appearance of the pilot workspace. Next, we continue with another gray plastic sprue. As you remember, we have two of them, so that's the last one. And this one sprue is dedicated to mix of various parts. We have, for example, some landing gear parts, one piece propeller here. Next, we continue with even some parts for the engine bay, because as you remember, we have nicely detailed engine here out of the box. You saw it on the previous sprue, so you can expose it on the finished model. And this is a really handy feature, especially in such tiny scale. It will be a cool addition which will be, let's say, noticeable, and it will be unusual for a small scale aircraft, especially BF109, which is not that big even in a 1/48 scale. So here you can take a, let's say, overall look at all these parts. I have to note that molding quality looks clean. There are no possible issues whatsoever. So it's just a matter of careful assembly and you will be good to go. And now I'm opening a clear plastic frame. So here we have canopy parts. And of course, you can open the canopy on this kit, which is quite important feature, because we have some nice cockpit details included out of the box, and you can also get some aftermarket PE in order to get even better details. But note that mask set is not included here, so you will have to do everything by your own hands, so be ready for that, or maybe get an aftermarket set from Edward and you will be good to go. Next, another plastic bag is dedicated to decals. So here we continue with two decal sheets. Here is the first one with tiny symbols. I guess that's maybe an errata note, because we also have a bigger decal sheet, and there is no mention where they were printed, but still printing quality is quite nice. Let's close the lenses a bit, and here you can take a closer look. So for example, we have really good symbols for the FizzyWatch, and also we have some stencils included, and this is really surprising in a 1/72 scale. So I'm really happy to see this included, because it will help your model to look even more realistic. And here you can also see some parts or decals for the cockpit. So we have seat belts, we also have instrument panel decals, and in my opinion this should be enough for a nice result, so do not underestimate it. It will be a good looking thing once you apply them all and maybe cover them with necessary layer of gloss lacquer, let's say. Next, we continue with assembly manual. So here I should zoom out. It's a typical special hobby brochure. It is printed in color, and we have short history note in two languages on the first page. Next, we continue with the parts map, and I have to say that the parts map here is quite, I would say, easy to understand. You have this red crosses, which mean that these parts will not be used in the assembly. And assembly process starts with the cockpit floor. So again, we have quite an interesting solution that assembly manual or assembly manual schemes are combined also together with a marking guide, and it's shown with colors so that it will be easier to understand. And that's really great. It might be handy for beginners. Next, you see the assembly process for the engine. So here you have to decide whether you would like to expose it or you would like to hide it, and based on this you will have to choose the next parts for the assembly. As you remember, we have a one-piece cowling, so that's why I think it's worth exposing the engine on your aircraft, because it will give even better appearance and effect to your model. But you can also get the resin engine for this kit. That will be even better, because there are some minor and, let's say, fine features included in the resin, which cannot be copied out of the box in the plastic kit. So that's why definitely think about it if you want to build something more advanced. Here we continue with wing mechanization and air intake. Also small add for some resin accessories from CMK. Here we have canopy parts, so again you have an option to open the canopy, as you remember, and that's the first marking option with 1, 2, 3 number on the tail, and also this sign which was also on the box art. And just to remind you, we have 3 marking options included, so here we have other 2 which can be copied with the decals out of the box. This one is quite famous in my opinion, but still I think it should be a quite great project for all fans of German aircraft, especially in a small scale. Here, by the way, you can see a small ad for other releases of this kit in a 1/72 scale. So we had E1, E3 and E4 version. All of them were reviewed on our YouTube channel, so you can find it easily just by typing the kit name and kit number. As for this kit, it should be already available. You can get it on official Special Hobby website. Of course, I'll be happy to hear your opinion about this release here in the comment section below. If you like this video, press the like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I will see you in the next video review as usual. Thank you for joining me today, and bye!